Hey everyone, so here is my output actually. So I just developing that simple chatbot using OpenAI with Python actually. So previously I had a same video, but that video will contains that React.js with OpenAI, but there is a drastic changes will happen in that OpenAI side actually. So that's why that code will it not work for the many of the users actually. So that's why I just recreated that video. Please give your support and let's deep dive into that. So before we are going to that, I'll just put it some sample text. So I'm already asking some of the questions. The OpenAI will return based on that actually. So I'm gonna ask actually. So what is C++? So if I ask that simple questions, so it will, as per the same thing, it will go to the backend that OpenAI and it will be get the result from there actually. Yeah, so here's the result. So C++ is general purpose, high level programming, etc, 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 like that actually. So here is the video. Today we are going to talk end to end. So how to create a simple chatbot using OpenAI with Python actually. So don't skip that video. Let's deep dive into that. So all right, so before diving into the code part, so we need to define that project structure as well actually. So in that so let me define that project structures for our chatbot application actually. So in that I can create a first parent folder in that ChatGPT, so like that. So example, so I can just create one folder and so this is the main thing. And in that I need to keep that some static objects as well, like images, audios, like that actually. So in that I can create a one folder called static. And the next part, I need to maintain that HTML files as well actually. So in that I can put that template because it's a Python project, right? So that's why I not keep it in that SRC. So that's it. And the next thing, directly I can create a main file called app.py. And that another important thing is we need to requirements.txt, we need to return every projects actually, just keep it in that mind actually. And the next thing, so in that template folder I need to create a HTML file. So in that I can just create a index.html as well actually. So this is the thing, I'm going to define the structure. And in the static level, I'm already keep that some of the images, so I just put it over there. So this is why ChatGPT logo and that our channel logo as well actually. And in that template folder wise, so index.html we can keep it, but in that static level, so we need to keep another file called stale.css. so that file I can keep it actually. So here is our project structures. So the next part we can, so let's start with the app.py actually. So in that I'm gonna first start that that simple Flask server actually. And also I need to include that OpenAI library as well. So actually the three libraries we mainly need, and the Flask, and the next thing is OpenAI actually. So that we can add it in that requirements.txt later actually. So let me go to that main thing actually. So in that, so I'm gonna just put that from Flask, in that Flask and a render template and a request, and along with that OpenAI. So I can just add it over there. And the next thing, I'm gonna first initialize that Flask. So app equal to Flask. So in that I can just put it that name as well actually. So that's all. And so in that first I need to get that OpenAI API, and along with that I need to define that API key as well actually. So in that I'm gonna put OpenAI dot key, so API key. So in that, for now I can just put that empty thing. Later I can add it over there. So the next thing, I need to define that first that rendering that template as well actually. So in that app.route, so in that as the home page should be a render template actually. So index, and in that index of we can return render template. So in that render template level, we already created that index.html, so over there right? So in that index.html, so I can just call it So that's all. That now that index.html will automatically will call it actually once we are hitting that home page actually. So the next thing, I need to create a API things actually, app.route. So in that slash API, and in that methods, I'm gonna put, I say post actually, because I have a payload. So in that I will create a post method as well. And that next thing, I'm just creating that dev API. So in that, so first thing I need to get the messages from the post payload actually, so that I can put it actually. So now message variable will have that whatever chatbot level, if we put that some text, that text will reach through the message variable actually. And the next important thing is we need to create a OpenAI API calling actually. So in that I'm gonna type that completion equal to OpenAI chat completion dot create actually. So if I call that, so inside that I need to define that some of the required parameters actually. So one of the parameter is model actually. So model for, I'm going to use GPT 3.5 Turbo. So this is the model I'm going to use. And in that level, so I need to define that roles and content as well actually. So in that, I'm going to type, yeah. So in that messages level, role user, content message. The messages comes from that chatbot actually. So this is how it gonna to be a work. And the next part, I need to put that some validation. So in that, if completion choice, if it is not a none, so I need to return a message as well in the chatbot level. And after that, if anything is missing, so I need to return the error message as well actually. So that error message, so I can put yet else return fail to generate the response like that actually. So this is how will it happen that in that part actually. So once OpenAI will it return that proper response, I'm going to return that response. Otherwise, I will just simply return that fail to generate the response as well actually. So this is how, and the main thing will start that Flask server as well. And so in that Flask server, so name main and app.run. So this is all about that backend level. And the next thing, we'll go to the index.html, that HTML things actually. Let's go with the index.html because we already done that app.py. So in that we already written that what are the things necessary that we are completed. So we can just simply go to the HTML thing. So in that HTML level, I don't want to focus more and more designs on that front end side. So because we are very much focusing on the back end side, if back end is works, then we can modify the front end based on that our requirements actually. So that's why I'm going to jump to the first completed back end. And now I'm going to do that index.html. So in that, I'm going to write that HTML thing. And in that, first I need to defining that some header things actually, like mentioning that CSS and bootstrap and responsive things. So these are the things I need to put it right. So I'm gonna just put it over there. So so here is the thing, just chat app along with that. So I can just mention that what are the things I need so that I can just mention it actually. So basically I can take that some predefined CSS things. And also I'm going to write some custom CSS as well that I can show later. So here's the thing in the head level and that body level. So I'm gonna type that. Let me start with the body thing. So in that I can complete the body as well. So in that I'm just creating some basic chat application actually. So like chatbot along with that. So type your message here. And in that, so if I enter that some messages, so that message I can put it over there. So this is a very not a very in-depth big level chat box actually, just simple chatbot we can utilizing that OpenAI things actually. So in that I need to consider that time as well, so there's a lengthy process, so I can just skip that. So here is my script actually. So let me explain that code quickly. So I can basically set that set interval as a highlight all. That means once we get the response, so after that, that will be shown in the chatbot actually. So in that under the script level, so I can calling that query selector things. And so this is a chat box, message input, and a send button. So these are the buttons. I can get it over there. And after that, so I can create one function as well. So this function add message called. So in that I have a two parameters, message and is user message actually. So in that I will first get that messages, and once I get the message, and after that that messages will it append with some user icon, and in the chatbot. So once I send that message to the chatbot, that message will be in the top end actually. Once the response will it get from the OpenAI, that message will be second actually. So it's like a WhatsApp. So use sender and a receiver, sender and receiver, like that I can classify that. So this is just a basic thing. And in that send message, one function is there, right? So this send message, will it call the directly API method actually? So this API already we created in that Python. So in that, once we get that post messages thing, and just we get that messages from the text box in the chatbot. After that, I can just string any fee, and after that, I can send it to that actually. So once I get the message, so after that, I can read the message, and it will be appending to that content, and it will be concatenate with the chatbot icon. And after that, it will be appending with the child, and also it will be show in that, as you already see that, right? That hope you already see that in that introduction. So once response get from the OpenAI, automatically it will append to that icon. And after that, so we can easily to see that, okay, so once our message is getting actually like that. So, and also I can support that for that scrolling things as well. And so in that key down, click, so all those things will it get accept actually. So this is how that very simple HTML thing, I can written it over there. And the next thing, I already generated that CSS file using ChatGPT. So like that, you can generate same as. So what you need to do is just you can copy that whole HTML file and you can put it in the ChatGPT. It will be returning that full CSS thing actually. So here's the CSS thing. And so that's all. So let's start the server. All right. So before we starting our backend server in Python, the chatbot application, so we need to get that API key from that OpenAI. So without API key, this part is won't work actually. So what you need to do is you need to create a OpenAI account, that openai.com. so, and after that, once you created the account, platform.openai.com actually. So in that, you need to go to the profile icon, and in that there is a view API key is there, right? So there you can go. And so in that, you need to create a new secret key based on that actually. But you need to keep it in the mind. So once you created that account, so that OpenAI will allow for up to 6 months, you can easily to free to use that OpenAI, that access key actually. So after that 6 months, that API you not going to use, only you need to use with the paid application actually. So if you have any projects or if you have any demos, so you can continue with that free API keys actually. That's my suggestion actually. So this is how. So once you can just click that secret key, and you can put on secret key and create a new secret key like that. So after that, the key will be generate, and the next part you can take that key and you can put it in that our Python file. All right. So I'm already copied that my OpenAI API key. So I can just paste it over there. So for me, I can generate this key, and once we put out this key, after that only our script will work actually based on that actually. So under the next part, we can start the server as well actually. So in that, I can just click that, and after that, open integrated terminal. So in that, as you can, so easily you can simply run Python app.py actually. So if I run that, our server will start at 5000 port as per the things, and after that you can start that your browser actually. So in that, so here is my browser. So in that I can just open that localhost 5000. So in that, so this is my very simple chatbot, and in that if you see in that Python code level, so I can just simply start that Python app.py actually. So if I start that, automatically that server will start on the 5000 port. So if your port is busy, so you can change the port as per the what you wanted, like that actually. So the next thing, I can go to that, and in that, so I can just type it. So what is that? So what is Python? So Python programming. So if I enter that, so once if I enter that concept, so after that, it will be just appending with that user icon along with that that name. See, here is the thing. So in that response, I can immediately calling that because the post API will call. And after that, once I get that APIs, so I can just all the contents from the API response, I can concatenate with this icon. And after that, I can just put it over there. So Python is a high level interpreter language, etc., like that actually. So this is how that simple chatbot using that Python with HTML. So here is the next thing I gonna type. So like, what is subscribe? So if I just common questions, so based on that, so once it done, yeah, subscribe means sign up or enroll on a service, like that actually. So most of the thing, YouTube channels like that obviously, so don't forget to subscribe my channel actually. So and the next thing, so I can apply that scroll ball as well, and so in that you can just scroll into that actually. So this code I can add it in that GitHub, so that repository link I can add it in the description below, so you can check it below actually. So this is how that OpenAI with the Python, in that simple implementation, we can able to achieve those chatbot application actually. So hope you guys, you really like that video. So if you really like that video, please subscribe my channel for more videos like this in the future. And if you have any queries or if you have any issues, so leave them in the comment section below. I'm happy to respond, and I'm happy to sort it out as well actually. So we'll see you on the next video. Bye. Thanks. We hope you found this video informative and helpful. If you did, please hit the like button and consider to subscribe our channel for more videos like this in the future. Also, don't forget to share this video with your friends and colleagues who might find it useful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. And we'll be happy to respond. Thank you for watching. We'll see you on the next video.